MMP is not kind to minor parties. Ever since MMP began, the smaller parties in government have fared much worse at the following election. Tonight's One News Colmar Brunton poll has the Greens on 6% in the party vote. If it was an election, they would slip back into Parliament. But can they maintain their support? Green Party co-leaders Marama Davidson and James Shaw are with us. Tēnā kōrua.
Kia ora, tēnā koe.
Marama, let's start with you. 6% in party support. Are you confident at this stage you can maintain that level of support through to the election next year?
It's been consistent and it shows that we have been a green heart changing the way and influencing the way that this government works. Our goal is to protect people and the planet, and we've got the policies and the visions. What people need to know from us also, and what we need to keep talking about, is our track record. And that 6% is around the things that we've, the major wins that we've had, whether it is ending offshore oil and gas to protect our oceans and our climate, whether it is introducing the zero carbon bill to put our country onto a track to net zero emissions. It has to include the biggest single increase to the Department of Conservation that we've had in 16 years, and Jan Logie's work leading a violence-free future, world-first whole-of-government approach.
Don't worry, I will ask you more about your track record in a moment. I just want to focus on the numbers and how that might shake down in a year or so's time. James, if it got to the point where you were polling at 4% at this time next year, would you be prepared to do some sort of deal with Labor for a seat in, say, Wellington Central or something similar?
Well, we've been on 4% before, and we came back at the last election actually with only 6 weeks to go. And so I just don't think it's necessary. And the remarkable thing about our polling is that it has been rock solid since the election. I mean, we're the only party that's seen no variance at all. It'd be nice to be up a bit, but actually it's actually really good news. And it is counterfactual, as you say, if you look at the history of third parties in New Zealand. Actually, we do appear to be the outlier, and I'm absolutely sure that we're going to come back in.
Would you be prepared to work with National?
Look, I'm very happy with the government that we've got, and I would have to say that if they were prepared to change everything about the way that they're doing business, the idea that they're speaking out of both sides of their mouth on climate change, the kind of misinformation and the lies that they're spreading through their kind of attack ads and so on at the moment, I just can't countenance it. I think they're behaving appallingly at the moment.
Well, you heard Simon Bridges just a short while ago saying he would be prepared to work with the Greens if it came to that.
Well, he's pretty desperate. I mean, he's got no friends, and there's a reason for that. And I think the reason for that comes down to the way that they're behaving.
Look, we know that New Zealanders expect the Green Party, along with our track record and our big wins, we know that New Zealanders expect the Green Party to go faster and stronger on transformational changes to truly address climate change, species threats and inequality. And we cannot do that with the policies and the visions that the National Party hold. Our members ultimately decide who we will work with. But based on us having to push faster and stronger, that means that National would have to...
Marama, this is weird. I'm just going to stop right there. Sorry, I'll come back in a second. Yeah. Can you just move your hair slightly to the left? Sorry, otherwise everyone at home is going to be missing the words you're saying and focusing on the disturbance on the microphone. What policies have you passed that would not have been introduced under a Labor majority government?
I never thought in my lifetime I would see an end to new offshore oil and gas.
So that wouldn't have happened if it was just Labor?
It was the... actually the power of the people and a strong, green, consistent campaign over our whole entire political lifetime.
Wouldn't it happen if it was just Labour?
That remains to be seen.
Well, that's what I want to know,
though. It is a strong, green influence heart that makes sure that we push through the most transformational changes. The welfare, the advisory group about making sure our social service system is one that helps people rather than punishes, is because of a green confidence, a green agreement with Labour.
OK, how many of the recommendations
not enough
from the welfare?
So only three, and again, it is the Green Party who will continue to push for an overhaul.
No, but let's focus on that. When you became co-leader, you talked about how not being a minister meant you were free to call out Labor on policies the Greens disagreed with. But when those recommendations were released from the welfare working group, You said next to nothing.
Oh, we've said a lot.
No, they adopted 3 out of 42 recommendations.
And we've said that isn't enough. And we've said especially increasing the level of benefits so that people can live a life of dignity is a priority for the blueprint that that expert group came out with. And that is also a priority for the Greens. We've said a lot and we will continue to say that that will be a priority for the Greens.
But why isn't the government changing it? If that's such a priority to a major coalition partner, why isn't the government changing it?
And again, for us, that needs to be a core part of the work to address climate change and inequality.
I know it needs to be, but it's not changing at the moment. Winston Peters is winning lots of, you know, everywhere you look, the capital gains tax gone. The refugee policy looks like it's not going to change at the moment. No, but I mean, they've got $3 billion regional development fund. This is a core part of green policy. I mean, your fundamental principles are around climate change and economic inequality.
Yeah, we
and
agree.
Yet only 3 of the 42 recommendations
have been
taken.
This is only
so
the
far.
Start. Yeah, so far. And we will continue to keep pushing and working across with the ministers. We're in the discussions.
Okay.
Again, with the wins that we've managed to secure on 8 MPs, I know that we will do even more so if we can have even more support. But that is a priority for us to hold the line on the transformational change that needs to happen.
We know that the City Mission, the Salvation Army, both say that in the last year and a half, poverty standards have not improved in New Zealand. Like I say, this is a fundamental part of green policy. Can you tell us that in the budget next year, benefits are going to be significantly increased as the welfare expert advisory panel recommended?
So we can't preempt what the budget is going to have this next year coming up, but it's absolutely a part of our priority, and that we are the political party to know that this is just not good enough. It is simply not good enough that people are lining up at 2 a.m. outside my local Manurua Work and Income office. We know that we have a progressive approach we're looking at. We need to look at a progressive tax system, ending homelessness, better housing.
When it comes
approach.
To coalition politics, though, why does Winston Peters seem to get a lot of what he wants, whereas you guys are still fighting for a really significant part of your policy platform?
Jack, so our confidence and supply agreement has got 20 line items on them. Mm. The last budget funded 16 of those line items. We worked out that there was about $6 billion of new capital and operational expenditure across across those 16 line items.
Just come back to that welfare report, though. 3 out of 42 recommendations.
Yeah, no,
this
true.
Is fundamental green stuff.
Look, we agree, but I guess that what you're suggesting is the idea that we're actually not getting anything out of being a part of this government is simply not true. We're actually making massive progress as a part of this government. Yes, we're not getting everything that we liked.
Yeah.
Nobody is, to tell you the truth. Nobody ever does. But we're making huge progress.
And we'll keep clear to people that those are the issues that they can depend on us to push for.
Marama, what should the government do at Ihumātao?
So I'm glad to see that what James and I asked for months ago was to not wash the government. The government cannot wash its hands of it. It's good to see that they are listening to the protectors on the ground. We knew that they weren't going to go away. We knew that you couldn't simply ignore them. And there needs to be a process for all of the interested here, because going on what Mr. Bridges said, it does not have the support of all the local iwi. It just does not.
No.
And so there needs to be discussion held to come to a peaceful
sort of
solution?
What sort of solution could be reached?
It's not for any politician to dictate what the solution will be. The mana whenua, everyone involved, this is not easy. Everyone involved needs to have a careful conversation about what the outcome would be. The first step is making sure that government is not just listened to, the voices it selects to listen to.
Would you support the government by that land?
That's obviously one of the options on the table.
Would you support that?
Yeah, of course, if that was what mana whenua
But would that not undermine every treaty settlement up to this
point? So we don't have to create a treaty precedent here. We can be quite creative and look for a collaborative approach, an innovative approach to retaining that amazing, beautiful land for the benefit of all New Zealanders, protecting its cultural and heritage significance.
I know there are some people, though, who would say that that would set a dangerous precedent when it comes to treaty settlement.
And that's why, again, we can instead have an innovative, collaborative approach. We could approach local local council, local government and other funding partners. But again, mana whenua, being able to talk through the various options is where we need to start.
James, next year we know that the budget responsibility rules, so-called budget responsibility rules, are being changed somewhat, that our debt limits are being expanded. Upon reflection, were those rules worth it?
Well, you've got to remember that in 2015-2016, there wouldn't have been a single member of the media and much of the public who believed that we were in a position to change the government. And they didn't believe that Labor and the Greens would be able to work constructively together to form a government and to be able to maintain a government. So we had to send some kind of signal about what, you know, the kind of envelope was that we were going to operate within. Was it worth it? You know, it is one of the salient lessons when you get into government and you get a lot more information than you get in opposition. One of the things that's happened since we got into government, of course, is that our cost of borrowing, which was already low, has actually now gone down even more to the lowest level of cost of borrowing in recorded history. And, you know, we also know that the infrastructure deficit, the housing deficit and so on is just colossal.
Failing.
And so, you know, I mean, one of the things that Grant has signalled is that once the current budget period is out, that,
what,
you know,
was it worth
there might be a bit more scope. Was it worth it? Look, I can't...
It sounds like you're saying no.
No, I'm just... I can't...
And that's okay.
...on that. I think, you know, in the political climate that we were at, where the prevailing narrative was that is the only thing that you've got social licence to do, we felt that we had to send that signal.
We've seen inside the books now, and we're failing, and we need to consider all the options for properly funding public services, and that's something that we're keen to look at.
Yeah, which is why we said that we would review it and go into the next election with a different set.
Thank you very much, and good luck for your party conference
Jack.
This weekend.
Thank you.